hello everyone, welcome back to Pwn TV. So, I really liked making that video about my favorite ammunition in Final Fantasy XI, and I thought I'd make a series and do the other pieces. I mean, everyone saw this coming, right? So, here we have the favorite belts in Final Fantasy XI. This is my video on my favorite belts, and I have a list of 26 belts that I ranked from my least favorite to my most favorite, and we'll go through that list. Now, I've looked at it quite a bit already, so I really kind of agree with this, the way that I organized everything. So we'll go through this list, and the top of these belts at the top are going to be like the belts that I'm glad I have, but they're really not that exciting. And then the belts at the bottom of this list are going to be like, wow, those belts are super duper good, right? So we have 26 belts, and it's going to take more than 26 minutes to talk about it, so I want the video to not exceed 30 minutes, so I guess let's get started. We'll dive right into it. Top of this list, Lucidity Sash. This is your go-to piece if you're returning to the game and you want to play Summoner. I mean, it's still good after that. When you get better pieces, you can still use Elemental Siphon with this belt. It's great for that. So lots of good uses for this belt. You should get this belt if you don't have it. Everything on this list is something I think I would get again if I started another character, for sure. So if you're coming back to the game, get it as well. Sarissaphoroi belt. This is not that hard to get, and it has a lot of stats on it that can do a lot of things. But it does fall off, just like Lucidity Sash. There's just better things that you can get down towards the bottom of this list. But for, you know, where you're at right now, if you're coming back to the game, this is a really good return piece. It's just so many things you can do with it on so many different jobs. Solo Belt. I really only got this for the Amity Spike, but the Attack 30 is relevant for, like, Abyssy content, for example, if you really want to just grind out Abyssy. Whatever you're doing, I don't know, but if you're doing low-end content, you need the Attack Spike to just kill things faster. Yeah, Solo Belt would be good for that, too. But mostly it's for Amity Plus. You can do so many different spells, job abilities on so many different jobs with this gear, and it helps you keep that Amity. If you're trying to pull hate off of somebody, you could just easily do that with an Amity set. This is part of every Amity set that I make, basically. Really good. Seagull Sash. Okay, you could play the game without Seagull Sash. You could play the game without anything on this list. But do you want to have a Stone Skin set? Do you want to have a set of gear that you blink into when you cast Stone Skin, and now your Stone Skin is like two Stone Skins instead of one? Because that's kind of how it works out when you have enough gear. Yeah, I think I would rather have a second Stone Skin on top of my Stone Skin. Why not stack Stone Skins? So you can do that with this. You can add more HP absorption to your Stone Skin spell when you have that Stone Skin equip set. And this is part of my Stone Skin is equip set, and it's useful on so many different jobs. You can even sub a job that has Stone Skin, like let's say Pup doesn't get Stone Skin, but you could sub White Mage and have Stone Skin. Now Pup can have a better Stone Skin than they would normally have for subbing White Mage, because they have the gear that enhances it. You get the idea, right? So there's so many different jobs that can do this trick, so why not? Why not get it? If there's more than five or six jobs on the piece, it's a really good piece to get if you don't know what you want to play, because you can always hold on to it, and then you'll eventually run into a job that you want to play, and you simply just have more gear for that job suddenly. So don't throw stuff like this away if you do get it and you're not sure what to do with it yet, because I'm telling you that everything on this list is really useful for something. Issa belt is really good. All jobs, fantastic. If I'm using Geomancer, my bubble suddenly has all those pet stats. If I'm playing Summoner, my Summoner can suddenly tank better because it has all those pet stats. If I'm tanking a Puppet Master and my tank pup, my automaton that might be tanking the fight, if I want to make them tankier, I use this. Same with Beastmaster. If I want to tank on Beastmaster, I use this. I mean, there's not much else to say about it. It's just really good. I have a tell. Problem solved. Rumination Sash. Rumination Sash is really good. When I first came back to the game and I wanted to max out my Red Mage, I needed Magic Accuracy and Enfeebling skill to max out my Red Mage to land my Enfeebling spells, and I needed this. I looked up how to get it, and I grinded really hard to get it. I don't remember exactly how hard it was, but then I got it, and I was really excited about it. And I got better stuff after that, but I'm still excited about Rumination Sash nonetheless. You have to get this piece of gear. It's super duper good, and there are better things on this list than this gear for, like, say, Red Mage Silence spells, etc. But with all that set aside, it also comes with Spell Interruption Rate 10, so you can stack Spell Interruption Rate down in this game. 10 more Spell Interruption Rate could mean the difference between you getting off your cure spell and you dying, so Rumination Sash will help you with a lot of content, period. Also, mind 4. Casting your cure spell, you've got 4 extra mind suddenly, just out of nowhere, in your mid-cast set. Okay, great. Sounds good. Sylphie belt plus 1. Hey, I mean, Paladin is a great job, right? Well, it also has a lot of armor that doesn't have high haste, especially after Odin was released, because they gave us Hijirandi helmet and Hijirandi body armor, and those pieces don't have any haste, I think, or very little haste, if whatever. It doesn't put you where you need to be, which I believe is around 26% haste, but if you have Sylphie belt plus 1, you already have, you get an extra 9% haste, and that basically closes the gap that you're introducing with all this new gear that has low haste on it. You could just put this on with that other gear and compensate for that low haste on that other gear, and you're good to go. And so that's why I have it, because it really puts me where I need to be on my haste cap. Also, it comes with triple attack. So if I'm using Zantetsuken X on Paladin or Dark Knight or something, then I'm probably... Well, Dark Knight gets, I think, Eoskia belt or whatever, but Paladin doesn't. Paladin only gets this, so that's why I have it. So when I'm using Zantetsuken X on Paladin, now I'm suddenly really good at using Zantetsuken X on Paladin with that set of gear with low haste because of this 9 here on this piece. Regal belt. Not that hard to get. Most people that do OU are really, they already have this gear, and they're probably winning the content these days. Let's be honest. You don't usually wipe out to OU that often anymore. At least I don't. I beat him all the time, and I always see this item drop to the ground because all the summoners already have it. So very easy to get in that regard, because you could just pick up any OU run and pretty much guarantee that nobody's going to be lotting on your Regal Belt, so you could just grab that really quick. And it is fantastic on Summoner. It is like the only piece of gear I use in my belt slot on Summoner these days. Like 99% of the time, if I'm on Summoner, it's Regal Belt at this point. It really is. I mean, that's how good Regal Belt is. Very good piece. Incarnation Sash. This is just like Beastmaster's Regal Belt, honestly. It has been since I got it. Before I was using Regal Belt on Summoner, I was using Incarnation Sash on Summoner. And I still use Incarnation Sash on Beastmaster and Puppet Master. It's just a really good... Look at all the stats on this item, and then 15 events to back that up. Yes, very good item. Yamaya Belt. Okay. This is an interesting piece. When I first saw it, I didn't think I would ever use it, but then I got it, and I thought about how I would use it, and I found so many uses for it suddenly. So just because I happened upon this item, I just tried it out, and I found that I really like it. There is so many ways to use this item. If you don't have anything better, the store TP4 on this item is really good for anything that you need to generate TP with. I can think of a lot of examples. Your melee set, for example. If you're using Quick Draw on Corsair and you want your Fire Shot, for example, to do more, to return more TP, maybe not do more damage, but give you more TP back than it normally would, you can stack store TP on your Quick Draw set and you would use something like this, and that would give you more TP back on your Fire Shot. It does work that way, trust me. So you can stack enough store TP to use a Fire Shot and then another Fire Shot and then have 1,000 TP out of nowhere. You can do that. I have done it. So you would use things like Yamaya Belt in that case. But there are better things for that on this list, with store TP 5, for example, slightly better than this. So that's just one of the stats on this item, though. Everything else on this item is good in its own way. Rapid Shot for your Rapid Shot set, that's your precast set for your ranged attacks, that's great. You use that, you're going to actually spend less time staring at the monster while you're trying to fire your shot at him, because you have the Rapid Shot. Similarly, ranged accuracy, ranged attack, all that time you sat there and wasted using the ranged attack in the first place, now it's faster to do that, and also you're more likely to hit. So you're going to actually have, you're going to benefit from that time that you wasted. Whereas without ranged attacks, you could have just simply gone up and meleeed him and then probably hit him, because Core with swords and Savage Blade and all that is really good at meleeing as well. But that's just there's a lot of ways to use Yamaya Belt. I use it a lot on Thief and Red Mage as well. So if I need to go to the back, like go 20 yams away because I have like maybe 50 health and I'm really about to die, if I just need to get out of range, I can still DPS because I have things like this to actually give me the ranged accuracy spikes that I need to actually realistically do DPS from a distance on all those jobs. So yeah, really good piece. Engraved Belt. I love this. It was a nightmare to get it, but it was really fun to fight Carbuncle to get this item. You have to beat Carbuncle Prime to get this item. It's the Tier 2 Carbuncle Prime, so your high tier merit point BCNM Carbuncle Prime with the star quest. It's the BCNM with the star in front of the name. for Carbuncle Prime. And it's not easy to kill Carbuncle Prime solo. But if you find out how to do it, you can grind him out and then merc Engraved Belt by yourself on, like, Thief, and basically go one for one on Engraved Belt every time. There's a catch to doing this. I've learned this the hard way, that the best way to beat Carbuncle is by equipping Engraved Belt, and you have to actually not have it in your inventory in order for it to drop. So there's the catch. You have to beat Carbuncle without Engraved Belt, even after you won Engraved Belt, and even after you know Engraved Belt is best to beat Carbuncle with. You still have to delivery box it to yourself to get rid of it so you can see another one drop if you're solo. So that's funny. In my experience, it's a nightmare not having this when you're fighting Carbuncle. Try it sometime. Trust me when I say that beating Carbuncle with Engraved Belt is super easy, but beating Carbuncle without Engraved Belt is a fucking nightmare. All right, just trust me when I say that. There's just so many good things on this item. I could be here all day talking about why you should get it. Just trust me, you need this item. Everything below this item also. You probably need everything below this item, because now we're getting to the really spicy shit. There's a couple other non-spicy things on here for some of you guys, like, for example, Kentark Belt +1. I could think of a lot of uses for it, so it is on this list. It is farther down the list than Engraved Belt, but you're probably not using it. Like, if you're a summoner main or something like that, you've never heard of this, but this exists. Accuracy 14, defense 14, that's really high. Double attack 3 to back that up. Store TP 1 to 5. If you're in the best unity, you get 5 store TP. That makes it better than Yamaya Belt, so you can use it in your store TP set. Like, it's better in that set. So, lots of uses. But we are doing pretty bad on time, so I'm going to try to speed this up a little bit, even though this is the very good stuff. We're getting so deep into the really good belts in Final Fantasy XI. Eshin Stone is one of my favorite belts in Final Fantasy XI. I got this when I returned to the game, and I have no regrets. I can't play Final Fantasy XI without this belt. But now, having looked at it for so many different years, I see Magic Attack 7, and I frown because I wish I had more than 7 magic attack in that slot, because at this point the only way to get a better lead in salute, because this is best for lead in salute, if I'm not claiming perfect knowledge, but as far as I understand, this is best for lead in salute, this is best for Aeolian Edge, things like that, those sets I already kind of have maxed out, and the only way to improve them would be to retire Eshin Stone for something better, but nothing exists that I'm aware of that's better for, like, elemental weapon skills. This is just super duper good. That's why you would get this item. Really good for elemental weapon skills, and if you don't have anything better, really good to land your spells. Like, if you're a red mage returning player, all jobs can use this. If you're white mage returning player and you're trying to land silence and ambuscade, all jobs can use this. Hello, like, you get magic accuracy on all jobs, so don't overlook that. It can be the difference between a resist and a successful landing of a spell for every job in the game, so you should get this. Old Cinny Belt, all jobs, another piece that's all jobs. So if you play 22 jobs on Final Fantasy XI, like I do, well, this particular piece of gear is one inventory slot, and it can be equipped by all jobs in the game. And it can assist all jobs in the game at actually landing their melee attacks, because it has accuracy 20 on it. Accuracy 20 is best in slot on all jobs. So if you need high accuracy, and that's all you care about, then this is the one piece of gear I think anyone on any job would want to equip, because it happens to have all that accuracy. There are also certain jobs that get shafted on accuracy for their melee sets, like Scholar, for example. One example, there's plenty that I could list. Scholar loves Old Cinny Belt because it has the store TP and the accuracy on it, which gives you the TP, the successful attacks, which allow you to build the 1000 TP that you're required to have if you want to close Darkness in particular. So I'm playing a staff, I'm using a staff right now, so I'll just show you the weapon skills. So Shatter Soul is the one that I use on Scholar to close Darkness. So I'll do a distortion weapon skill with my stratagems. I'll just do distortion, and then after I see the distortion animation, I can close Darkness if I land Shatter Soul. So I have to have the accuracy for that, okay? That's why we have the Old Cinny Belt, because it really helps you do that, pull that extra tech off successfully. So really, really strong piece of gear. All jobs. I love it. Moving on. Oneros Belt. There's a lot of ways to use equipment that only has HP on it. This happens to be best in slot for HP. So if you're blinking into a fast cast set and you notice your HP is getting chunked as a result of cutting all of it off to compensate in lieu of fast cast gear. Words don't work today, I guess. So if you're subbing out HP for fast cast on your set when you blink into your fast cast set, it really hurts you when you blink out of it because your HP will go back, your max HP will go back up a lot, and you'll have a chunk of it missing because you blinked out of that set in the first place. Well, if you make a hybrid set instead that has fast cast where it counts and HP where it counts, then you can create a really functional fast cast set that doesn't chunk your HP nearly as much. And so that's what I would use Onero's belt for in most cases. Also, I really like it for Atonement on Paladin because there's nothing better in that slot. When I blink into my weapon skill set for my Atonement weapon skill, I lose a lot of HP on Paladin. So this kind of helps me close that gap a little bit. So definitely need to get it if you're playing a mythic Paladin. If you have Mythic Paladin, if you have Bird Gang, you have to get this belt. Otherwise, you're doing it wrong, honestly, if you ask me. There's no better piece. Flume Belt plus one. This is really good, guys. You're using this a lot on any tank job that you play. Even if you're an off-tank, even if you're a melee DPS like Thief, and you pull hate, this is a great item to just have if you're about to pull hate and take some damage. There's just so many ways that you can get out of damage with this item. You got high defense. 15 is like best you'll ever see. You have vitality. You have the physical damage minus. Okay, and then after all that, now you're getting MP back after you take the damage. So you take the damage, you take 2% of that damage, you throw it in your mana pool every time. So that's just how this works. So for all those jobs, maybe you're subbing White Mage, you want more mana to cure, then you can do that suddenly because Flume Belt's helping you get your mana back. It's like a refresh without actually having refresh, provided you're actually taking physical damage or whatever damage. It's any damage that says. So yeah, some pieces are only physical, some pieces are all types. This is all types. Really good item, you should get it. Fosha Belt. This is not that easy to get, but you won't regret it once you get this piece. This isn't, I want to say Abbasi, but I could be wrong. I know one of them is an Abbasi, and then the other one is, I think the Gorget, the Fosha, the neck piece, Fosha piece, is actually a C piece from Lumoria, but I could be wrong. I could be backwards or whatever, but whatever the case is, look up how you get Fosha Belt. Get Fosha Belt. If you're playing any job that wants to use a weapon skill, this is good. This is best in slot for a lot of those jobs. If it's a magic weapon skill, I would still argue that after testing, Ash and Stone is better for magic weapon skills, but if it's not magic weapon skill, then Fosha Belt is probably what you would want to use. Or if you just simply want to abuse the mechanic, TP not depleted when weapon skill used 1%. That's amazing. You get that on all the Fosha pieces, so that's 2% chance of activating, and you'll be surprised how often that is. And it can activate back-to-back, obviously, because it's just a percent chance of activating in the first place. So you could use it, it could proc, and then you could weapon skill a second time for free, and then it could proc again on that weapon skill. It could keep going indefinitely. Like, it's impossible, probably, but you know, in theory, you could go infinite weapon skills with this piece, right? Metal Singer Belt. Okay, maybe you don't care about the 1% proc rate on Fosha. Maybe you just want to max out your DPS. Well, Metal Singer Belt, if Fosha wasn't going to proc, Metal Singer Belt is still going to work. Like, it will always work because it doesn't have any 1% proc bullshit on it. It always does Strength 13, Double Attack 1. So that's just always going to happen. Plus Defense 15, meaning that if you blink into a weapon skill set and you have low defense on that weapon skill set, if you're using Metal Singer, now it's just better. It's twice as good as Fosha Belt, so you're not going to take nearly as much damage if you're taking damage while you're weapon skilling, and that could be the difference between a wipe and a successful win on the content that you're doing. So Metal Slinger Belt is definitely it flies really low under the radar in most cases. Most people are not aware of this, especially because you only really blink into it so much, so people returning to the game examining other players, they're rarely going to see this item. Fantastic item, you need to know about it. Grab it. It's super duper good, especially for Savage Blade. I really like it for Savage Blade. But if you're using Thief and you have Manda, which is the Relic Dagger, you use Mercy Stroke, that's a strength modifier. It's Metal Singer Belt is suddenly best in slot for Mercy Stroke because it's a strength modifier weapon skill, and this is Strength 13. It's insane. It's so insane for any strength weapon skill. So just grab it. Austerity Belt plus one. Okay. Let's talk about this. If you're playing Geomancer and you don't have this, you need to be slapped in the face. I'm sorry, don't play Geomancer without this. grab this or the normal quality equivalent. Those are your only two options for playing things like Geomancer. This is going to make it to where you never run out of MP, and you can actually use your support job. Because without this item, without conserve MP, without any sort of conserve MP set, you're going to be fucked on mana, and you're not going to be able to do your support job. So your support job might be Red Mage or White Mage or something like that. Whatever it is, you won't be able to function with those extra spells if you're not conserving MP on your Geo Bubbles. So every time you use a Geo Bubble, you spend 9 less MP, I think it is, to cast that bubble. So that kind of, you can see how that would benefit you in the long run. You save hundreds of MP after so many casts just because you're using this. So every time you cast a spell on those jobs, you're probably going to want to put this on. White Mage, if you don't have a better belt, put this on. Scholar, not a better belt, no better belt, put this on. You could just get it off Auction House. I believe it's Walk of Echoes to get this. It's kind of expensive, and rightfully so, because it's super duper good on Geomancer in particular, but it's worth it. It's worth every penny, and if you think it's too much, you can just go out and farm it. It's really not that hard. You can get it in a single sitting if you want. Easy peasy. Chack Belt. Well, guys, you know I like Thief. You know Treasure Hunter is important. If I want to raise Treasure Hunter value beyond 8, I need to stack Treasure Hunter equipment. Like, that's all I really need to say about this piece of gear. If I want to stack Treasure Hunter beyond 8, I need to stack Treasure Hunter Plus equipment. Chack Belt has Treasure Hunter 1 on it, so it's part of that set if I'm trying to actually raise Treasure Hunter, period. Witful Belt. Okay. Occasionally quicken spellcasting plus 3%. Well, as far as I understand, quick magic, which is basically what this is, caps at 10%, and this is 3 of that. Perimede Cape is 4, so that's 7. You also get 2 on Lebechi Ring. You get 1 on Verifil whatever ring, the ring that works only in Ambuscade Legion zones. So what is that? That's 10 right there. And if not, then you also get 2 extra on your ammo, which we talked about in the ammo video. The Quick Magic plus 2 Impassions equipment had that. So you can easily get to cap in this game with all of those pieces of gear. This is part of that set. So if you want to just instantly cast back-to-back spells, maybe your entire party's dead and you want to raise them all really quick, this can proc up to 10% of the time, quick magic, and you can just instantly reset the cooldown on any spell you cast, and then just cast that spell again. Like, you don't even care. Fuck's given. You don't even care. The downside to using quick magic, though, is it doesn't, you never blink into your mid-cast set. You never blink into your mid-cast set. So if you're in a pre-cast set, and this is part of your fast cast set, your pre-cast set, whatever you want to call it, if this procs, that's all you got. So your fast cast set, word to the wise, guys, turn your ears on for this one. If your fast cast set is not hybrid, or if you don't have half of it done and you have spaces available to put other pieces of gear on, or if you have all of the pieces in the game but you don't need that many, you probably want to start freeing up some slots for magic accuracy if you're using any quick magic in your set. That way, when the quick magic procs, you still have magic accuracy pieces equipped, and you don't have just all that shit as fast cast suddenly. And because all your fast cast pieces pretty much don't have magic accuracy on them, so your spell's just going to get resisted, buddy. I'm sorry to break it to you, but that's just how this game works. So think about that. Make that hybrid set with magic accuracy and quick magic. Make that hybrid set with quick magic and whatever it is you're trying to cast, like stone skin. If your spell is a stone skin spell, quick magic plus a bunch of stone skin enhancement pieces, that would work. So there's just a couple of examples. There's hundreds of examples of how you would want to do a hybrid set with quick magic just to kind of get around that little setback. But in the most cases, it's really relevant. Like Black Mage, for example, I'm on Black Mage right now. I cast a Thunder 6. If quick magic procs, well, I don't hit for nearly as hard, but I can suddenly just cast it again. So, good. Good stuff, right? Fucho no Obi. Fucho no Obi is great. Everyone needs this item. When you're at 50% or less total magic, then you just get refresh plus 1 in the slot. There's nothing else in the slot that gives you refresh plus 1, so this is your best in slot piece for only under when you're under 50% MP. You use this, and it will just help you get right back up there. If you're not using it for that, the drain Asper potency is not bad, but most people are only really just blinking into this when they're low mana, and it's really good on all those jobs. Luminary Sash. This piece of gear is amazing. There's pretty much all jobs in the game can equip this. That's like half the jobs in the game or more. And it has so many relevant stats. High defense at 12, not 15, but really good still. Mind 10, MP45. If you're blinking, you're not really screwing your MP bar up nearly as much because you're blinking into this and it already has the MP45. So you're not cutting your MP short by doing that. Conserve MP on this gear means that if it's in your mid-cast set, you're actually going to save some MP when you cast your spell, and magic accuracy 10. Let's not forget the best thing that's on this particular piece of gear, and that is your magic accuracy 10. Eshin Stone only has 7 magic accuracy, so you just get 3 more magic accuracy suddenly out of nowhere. So that's what I was talking about. Like, there's certain ways to retire Eshin Stone. We don't have any better magic attack pieces at the moment, but we have a better magic accuracy piece, and that is Luminary Sash. Magic accuracy 10. Don't leave home without it. It's really good on a lot of jobs, including Red Mage, obviously, and Scholar, and all those jobs, basically. Sveltes Gores plus 1. This piece of gear, take a moment, laugh at it. I'll wait. It's fine. I don't mind if you laugh at this piece of gear. I put it at the bottom of this list because it's one of my favorite pieces of gear. Period. This is my favorite list. I use this almost always. If you examine me and I'm playing Thief, you probably looked at a Sveltes Gores plus 1. Evasion 10, agility 10 means that I net 15 evasion while I have this equipped. That's really the only reason I have it. Resist gravity is cute, but I really never get, it really never lands anyway. And if it does, big deal. I mean, I could flee, I could just erase, whatever. Like, I don't even care about gravity because I have the evasion anyway. So even if I am gravitied, how are they going to hit me, right? How are they going to hit me? I have all this evasion, bro. Bro, you can't hit me. Bro, listen, this is a good piece of gear. No one uses it. I'm like the only person that uses it, but after posting this video, I'm sure I'll see it, because there's so many ways you can use this gear and just do so many things that you shouldn't be able to do. Like, pull on Thief. You could just go on Thief, and you could just pull every monster in the zone and just have an evasion set on and watch them miss you over and over again. That's totally fine, right? Well, that works. And if it's not evasion in that slot, you just put regen in that slot. So if they did hit you, you're healing already off of it. So you just stand there and watch them do nothing forever, basically, with stuff like this. So that's why I like it so much. Speaking of things that I really like, Asclepian Belt. Asclepian Belt is like god tier belt, honestly. For all 5 of these jobs, this is the best belt in the game, period. I mean, fight me on this. Fight me on this. Asclepian Belt is best gear in game. You'll probably be like, nah, bro, it's all about that, it's all about that Flume Belt plus 1, bro. Or, you know, whatever, like anything else on this list, right? But no, it's not. Listen, guys, listen to my story as I tell you my history with this item. Magic Evasion 20 is on this item. Let's tell you, let me let you know how insane this is, okay? Magic Evasion 20 means that I basically have a 20% bonus chance. I'm messing with the numbers a little bit. I don't know exactly how the math works out, but it's something like that. Of resisting any enfeeble that you use, basically. This is kind of the equivalent of Staunch Tathlum. If we look at Staunch Tathlum and you see resistance to all status ailments plus 10 on it, let me tell you a story. Okay? This basically says, when I get back to it, basically says resist all status ailments plus 20. And that's double Staunch Tathlum, isn't it? Yes, it is. In fact, it is. Yes, that's what magic evasion actually means in Final Fantasy XI. You're resisting enfeebles. You're resisting any magic. Any magic. If it's magic, you're evading it plus 20. Like, that's just how this game works. Sorry, I don't make the rules. I just play the game. So this is insane. This is super duper insane. For any time you're getting nuked by anything, you don't care. Oh, AoE Charmga? Don't care. Stack the resist charm, stack the magic evasion, boom, Asclepian Belt. That's in your set. It's super duper good. Oh, you don't quite have, maybe your Aegis is not equipped, your relic paladin shield, but you want your magic defense up there? Oh, you just suddenly have plus 3 magic defense. Great! Okay, there's just so many ways you can use this item. I can just put Aegis away and pull out my greatsword, and now I don't even care about Aegis because I have extra magic defense bonus anyway. Like, lots of, and evasion 20. Like, boom. boom, out of nowhere. Out of nowhere. Don't even care. Bro, this is fealty on a stick. That's what it is. I love Asclepian Belt. Guys, get this item. Get this item or I'm gonna smack you if you don't get this item. It is so good for so many different things. We didn't even talk about half the things on this item. Healing and Divine Skill 10, great. Love it. Subbing White Mage, fantastic. Now I'm even better. Okay, whatever. That's just one example. So many ways to use Asclepian Belt. I love this belt. Ever since I got it, I fell in love with it. It's a great belt. It's a fantastic belt. Everyone needs it. Everyone needs it. Speaking of things everyone needs, Reiki Yotai. This is your ultimate belt in Final Fantasy XI. Your ultimate belt. I think it might be the last belt on this list. Maybe. Maybe. We'll look in a minute. But let me talk about Reiki Yotai and how insane it is. First off, it's really hard to get. Is Kirin drop. You have to kill Kirin and Koryu in Esha Ruan, okay? So you do that, you get Reiki Yotai. Everyone's going to want it, so you're going to have to lot against people because it's a fantastic piece of gear. If you're dual wielding, best in slot Reiki Yotai. If you're doing any melee frontline DPS, best in slot Reiki Yotai because it has the dual wield on it as well as the store TP, which makes it better than Kintaro Belt plus one suddenly because the four store TP is good enough when you have the dual wield attached to it, right? Oh, and it is the last one on this list. Look at that. Okay. Yeah. So, end-all, be-all belt. Ultimate belt. Right? And probably, it's not my favorite. Honestly, my favorite is Svelte Escortus and Asclepian Belt. They're kind of all tied, though, honestly. But this is my strongest, I would have to say. This is my strongest for all intents and purposes on all those jobs. Look at the stats on this belt, guys. Take a minute to look at the stats. Oh, you can't equip your fucking Yemei belt for whatever reason? Oh, you're playing a job that's not on this list? Oh, double check. It's a different list, isn't it? It's quite longer. It's much longer than that other list. That means more jobs can equip Reiki Yotai, which means I suddenly have a ranged accuracy piece for those jobs, whereas I didn't before with the Yemaya belt. So yeah, that's just one other thing that Reiki Yotai does. While it's busy doing all this other shit, it's also giving you your ranged accuracy and your accuracy. Oh, you got hate? Blink into this. Take off your fucking plus three enmity on your solo belt. Just drop that really quick and put Reiki Yotai on and then start attacking. And then you generate less enmity and you're good to go. And that's it for this list, guys. That's it for this list. I've talked about every piece of equipment that I use in my belt slot that I really like. And that is the list. Thank you for watching the video to the end. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.